everyone. We're going to do another update on our garage to shop conversion. Of course, the floor is all finished. Now we're working on the wiring for the lights. Recessed lighting fixtures. I've got two strings already set up down that side, down both of the sides. finishing up through the middle. I have one more box to put in. I had to wait on those till last because that was, at that point in time, was the only light source that I had coming in here, plus was on the line that I'm going to actually tie into for the lighting system. Now what I'm using is these recessed lighting fixtures. Now these are designed actually for being able to use them in insulated attics and so forth, so they're sealed off so that you don't get stuff in. But they're fairly easy to install. Again, I got these ones at Lowe's. I think they were about, I'm going to say around $8-$9 a piece. So not the higher end ones. These were basically one of the lowest ones they had. And they happen to be sealed for insulation capability, which I really don't need, but hey, it's the way it is. And of course, this slide adjustment is designed so that you can spread it apart, shorten it up. If necessary, you can take this apart and cut off segments, which is what I had to do for these areas. They were too long to be able to install them, so I had to cut off a section, and that allowed me then to have enough adjustment inside to set them up. Right now, I just have them kind of toenailed in with the nails that are supplied. You can install them that way and leave them that way if you want. I'm going to go back in with some small quick draw screws. I don't like driving nails in real far. For me, in case I ever want to move things around in the future or whatever, it's easier to take apart if you just have screws instead of trying to pull nails out. So the electrical line that I need to tap into, actually the main power for it comes in from this portion of the wall. So I gotta reroute this. I wanna lower it down a little bit. So it comes over to here. There's an outlet box into the room on the other side. And I won't go into how this thing was rigged up, but there used to be a bench here. It was tied into that outlet, brought up through the bench, and then tied into these. There used to be electrical lines going all around the back of the wall. And then from here, it actually comes over and goes in. There's a closet on the other side that they have an outlet in. And then it comes back out up there. So that's going to be my main power coming in. So what I need to do is route that so that it comes over to here. And this is where my switch boxes are going to be put, where the existing one is on the other side. Now, the way it's wired right now is that main power come across and drop down onto this light switch or light fixture. And then they used a three-wire wire configuration because they kept one wire as a main power and it come over to this other light fixture and then ran down. So it's a three wire that's coming out. Basically they separated the power line so they could tie the power line back into the wiring here that went into another outlet inside, an outlet outside, and then there's also wiring up here that went to an outside light above the garage area. So that's going to come out. It's going to have a separate power line come in. I'll put a box in just for that to draw the power off for the light switches and to reestablish that connection there. So I got to rewire that. Right now, I have it hooked in to the dark wire up there. There's a box up there. That was a separate line that come in here. It was used for a wall outlet on the side over here and also a back light in the back side of the house, and then a wire that ran out to an exterior garage. That is not being used for anything at this moment, so I temporarily just tied into that line. That's the line I'm going to use for the power equipment for along the side of this wall when we get to that point. So right now I got one more box to put in. And again, these are designed with these quick install nuts. Basically, you just trim the end of the wires off and you poke them in there and it grabs a hold of it. So it makes the wiring portion real easy. It has knockouts on the tops and the sides, then also these small knockouts. If you use the round knockouts, you can use a strain relief adapter that you can just pop in there and screw it on, and then you can clamp down the wire. I don't have a real reason to use those or the reason to go to the expense of using them. So what I basically am doing is I'm just going to use the outside relief openings here and knock those out just to run the wire in. I don't have any strain relief issues because I've taken a wire nail and tightened them down. So that's, and there's really not going to be any strain on these because they're not going to be moved or moving around. So that's about where we're at the moment. And again, I just ran another line down here and put them in a switch box so that I can have access to the lights. And so far it's lighting up pretty good. Once I get the other line in here, we'll get this finished up. I'll maybe take a few shots here. I have another, this last box has to go in this area right here. So I'll kind of go through the steps of putting it in and maybe do some shots of the wiring and so forth. So stay tuned. Thanks. Okay, we're gonna see if I can do a quick installation here of this last fixture so you can basically see how it goes on. I have a bad rotator cuff on my left arm, so I can't really lift it up. So this is always tricky to me when I work on overhead stuff. But basically, you're gonna set this up in here and I slide it all the way over for myself, because that way I have something that my arm can control. Once it's up, I can, as long as it connects to something, I can manipulate it. But I have a mark here, and I have a mark here on the other joist, measured over a certain distance. In this particular case, it's 38. So I line it up right here to this side, and then this little catch is supposed to go lip underneath the joist. So we're going to just set that in there and kind of get it so it's stuck in a little bit. And we're going to tap this in. Screws in, and I come over here to this side and kind of make sure it's not bound or tightened. And as usual, it usually kind of goes off crooked because the way I have to do things with my arm. So that's enough to kind of hold it in place. Then I turn around, get my arm up here. Nope, no, that broke loose. Get this one started. Get a tap on it. And we'll get this back up here again in position. Make sure that there's no slack in here that's gonna make a bind. Okay, that one's in good. Let's do this one again. That lined up. Just enough to hold it. Of course, they're loose. But again, I'm going to put some screws in here and not worry about the nails, because I don't really want to use little nails later on if I decide to change things around. Okay. So, fixtures now. And again, it's designed to slide. There are screws on each side that you tighten down to clamp it in place. So once I center this or to the measurement position that I want it, I know in the middle where I had to cut it down, I had to move everything all the way to one side to get it in the proper length position. So
we'll get this positioned and get these screws tightened up, hold it in place, and then we'll do the wiring.
We'll do a shot of that. Thanks for watching.